Hi, I'm Oscar van Deventer, and this is the Gardner Ball. It's a tribute to Martin Gardner. It's based on a tessellation by Scott Kim, who wrote the name Gardner horizontal and vertical in many ways. And he asked me to turn it into a sphere as a tribute commissioned by Tom Rogers for the Gathering for Gardner. So this YouTube video will show the post-processing of the ball after it was 3D printed. So this is what the Gardner ball looks like when I get it out of the box. It's still all white, and here you can see in more closely how fine and detailed all the parts are. This is a little demonstration how strong the Gardner ball is. It looks delicate, and of course in your hand you can easily squash it. You really should pack it carefully when you're traveling, but still on its own it's quite strong. I can have it bounce on the floor and really nothing happens with it. Everything stays as it should be. So of course I can squash it with my hands and I can damage it, but on its own it's really strong. For the dyeing of the puzzles, first I have to put them in water and have them soak for a couple of hours. So I'm going to soak the Gardner ball together with some other puzzles that I'm working on. Here's a puzzle with some gears. A small part, and finally got the Gardner ball. Because it's so delicate, I put it on top and then just add water. Well, it's obvious that the ball doesn't even touch the water. So I have to find another solution to get the ball submerged in water. So here's the Gardner ball in boiling dye to make it yellow. I'll boil it for 20 minutes and it's together there with some other parts. So after dyeing the pieces, they have to dry. You see I've used different colors, yellow for the Gardner ball, but also some other colors just to give you an idea what the colors look like. And we can already see that the bright yellow, it's much better visible than the original white. So this is the reason why the puzzle definitely needs to be colored. The final step in making the Gardner ball is using a marker to paint one Gardner black. So that is how the first prototype of the Gardner ball was finished. As I had already shown you, it's quite strong despite its fragileness. So as I showed, it bounces. And well, you can squash it with your hands, but otherwise it's really strong and, well, very successful prototype. Thank you for watching.